So if you have your Bibles, keep them open to chapter 10.
如果你有带圣经来，请你把圣经翻到希伯来书第十章。我们先从第十章看。
We're going to use more verses than what you just read.
我们刚才读的这些的经文，我们是要看，但是我们要看的经文是超多过那些，所以如果你有圣经，最好翻到圣经希伯来书第十章。
Now, last week, we learned how the true prayer is making contact with God.
上个星期我们讲到了一个真正的祷告是应该什么呢？是应该要跟主、跟神有亲密的一个真正的个人的接触。
Now, today, in verse 19, the Lord tells us to enter confidently the holy place where we can contact Him.
在十章的第十九节说，我们得以坦然进入至圣所，去跟主有接触。
You see, that's what it says there. We have confidence to enter the holy place.
大家看见这个十九节的这个用词，说是得以坦然的进入。
And what we have to think about is what we are to do when we are there in that holy place.
我们需要知道一件事情，如果我们进到这个至圣所里面，我们去做什么呢？
Now, according to that verse 19, that holy place was made available to us by the shedding of Jesus' blood.
根据第十九节是说呢，我们印着耶稣基督的血呢，我们就可以进入到那个至圣所里面去。
You see the way it says it here, we have confidence to enter the holy place by the blood of Jesus.
因为他这里讲说，我们既因着耶稣的血得以坦然进入至圣所。
And then he goes on and tells us that the blood of bulls and goats can't take away sin.
然后他接着说，这牛羊的血呢，不能洗净人的罪。
See, that's up in verse 14.
在第十四节是这样说的。
No, it isn't. Verse 4.
在第四节，对不起。
And it is impossible for the blood of bulls and goats to take away sin.
在第希伯来书十章的四节说，因为公牛和山羊的血断不能除罪。
But just a minute. God gave the law. It was God who gave the law to Moses.
但是大家要仔细用头脑想一下，这个献牛羊的血，这个祭司系统是耶和华亲自吩咐摩西的哦。
And it was God who told Moses, who told them what animals had to die for what sins.
而且耶和华亲自很具体地告诉他们说，你犯什么罪，你就要献什么样的祭物，你是要做什么样的礼仪。
So, it was God who gave the law.
那所以这个律法和仪文都是耶和华所颁的。
But then, what does it mean here? It is impossible for the blood of bulls and goats to take away sin. What's he talking about?
但是希伯来书十章四节这里说，因为公牛和山羊的血断不能除罪。那这个是在说什么呢？怎么会自相矛盾呢？
Now, we know, the law was given to show us our sin.
大家知道律法的用意是让我们知罪，是让我们显明我们有罪。
And the law was given to show us that the only payment for sin is death.
另外呢，这个律法是告诉我们罪的工价，罪的唯一的这个代价，除罪的这个代价就是死。
That's why for all the different sins, there was a different animal that had to die.
所以因为这个缘故呢，你犯不同的罪，就有不同的动物要替你的罪而流血。
But whenever sin was involved, a death had to happen.
只要有罪发生，那么一定会有死与之相来。
Now the problem is this: bulls and goats were not perfect sacrifices.
但是大家牢记一件事情，公牛和山羊它们并不是完美的祭物。
But they formed a stopgap till God's perfect sacrifice would come.
但是他们做了一个什么？做了一个符号，一个形式，使得真正的上帝的祭物到的时候，大家都能够辨认出来。
Now we have to pay attention to this. We know God's perfect sacrifice was Jesus.
我们都知道这个上帝完美的祭物是耶稣。
Now, when he came.When Jesus came into the world, he said something here.
当耶稣降世的时候，他在世上的时候，他说了一些话。
Verse 5.
在第五节。
Sacrifice and offering thou hast not desired.
他说，神啊，祭物和礼物是你不愿意的。
In the law, you had to have sacrifice and offerings. God told him to do it.
在犹太的律法系统里面，耶和华吩咐说：“你们要献祭物，你们要献礼物。”
But when Jesus came, he says, "Sacrifice and offerings, you didn't want that."
但是第五节说，当基督到世上来的时候，说：“神啊，祭物和礼物是你所不愿意的，就是你不要。”
But then he went on and he says, "But a body you prepared for me."
你要的是什么呢？你曾给我预备了身体。
Now, I look back in the Old Testament, and where does it say a body was prepared for him?
所以我就去查圣经，在旧约圣经里面拼命的查，去查说哪里说了说耶和华曾给耶稣预备了身体。
No, I didn't find any statement was said just exactly like that.
我在旧约圣经里面实在没有找到一句完整的一模一样的这句话，在旧约里面没有找到。
But the Bible does say it.
当然，圣经是说了这个。
Because in Isaiah 9:6,
大家记得在以赛亚书第九章的六节怎么说
？It says, "Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given."
他说什么？有一婴孩为我们而生，有一子要赐给我们。
And Isaiah 7:14 says, "And a virgin will be with child, and will give birth to a son, and his name will be." Emmanuel, God with us.
后来在第九章又说什么？他说童女必要怀孕生子，然后呢，你们要取名给他叫以马内利。
So what Jesus was saying is that, I'm coming now to fulfill those prophecies.
耶稣实际上是在讲什么意思呢？说为什么说给我预备了身体呢？就是我来是要应验这些先知的预言。
A body was prepared for me.
这个给我曾经预备了这么一个身体，在神的计划里面预备好了。
Now, what is happening here?
那么到底这现在是要发生什么事了呢？
A change is being made from the Old Testament law.
在旧约圣经的律法里面做了一个改动。
Listen to this. God.Wants a sacrifice that man cannot do.
上帝真正要的祭物不是人可以献的，是这个人也献不了的这么一个祭。
All the sacrifices of the Old Testament law, it was men that did it.
所有在旧约这个时代里面，所有这个人手所献的祭都是人所献的祭。
It was animals that died, but it was the animals that belonged to men.
这些公牛也好，山羊也好，是死了，但是这些的祭物都是属于人的东西。
But those animals were not perfect sacrifices.
那么，但是这些的祭物属于人的祭物都不是完美的祭物。
And God says, "I want a perfect sacrifice that."Will do the job completely.
但是耶和华说，我要一个完美的祭物，使得他可以完美的成就我的计划。
But it had to be a sacrifice. That would have to be a sacrifice that no man could do.
那既然是一个完美的祭物，这个完美的祭物就一定不是你我这样一个不完美的人所能够献的，所能够预备的。
God had to do it.
所以完美的神自己必须要来预备这头祭物。
So Jesus came to do God's will.
所以主耶稣他来是要成就上帝的旨意。
Can you imagine here Can you understand a little bit more just what grace means?
大家可以通过这件事情可以更多的了解一点什么叫做上帝的恩典吗？
I mean, here I'm, what I'm saying here is just explaining grace.
我现在在跟大家讲的这一个道理，实际上是在解释上帝的恩典到底是什么。
Something man cannot do.
是那些什么？是人不能做的这些事。
But God did it.
但是呢，神成就了。
And we are the ones that profit by it.
我们这一些人呢，是受益的这些，我们得到好处。
And as Alex said in his talk, I mean, we don't deserve it.
就像 Alex 弟兄领圣餐的时候讲的，这不是我们人配得到神这样的恩典的，我们该上十字架。
And so it is God has done something that that we profit from, but it cost him everything.
这个神做了他做的事情，得好处的是我们。然后呢，神付出的代价是为了人的好处呢，神付出的代价是把神所有的都舍弃。
Now, you look at verse 9.
大家再来看第十章的希伯来书十章的九节。
By doing God's will, Jesus took away the first covenant.
这个照着上帝的旨意来，他来做什么事情呢？他是把第一次所立的约呢，就把它拿开。
You see what it says here? Behold, I have come to do thy will. When he said that,He takes away the first in order to establish the second.
在希伯来书十章九节说，后又说，我来了，为要照你的旨意行。可见他是除去在先的，为要立定在后的。
There is a second. There was a second covenant had to be established.
一个旧约以后的一个新约必须的要被建立。
So Jesus, in verse 16.Has made a new covenant with us.
所以在第十六节，耶稣跟我们立了一个新约。
Now look at what it says. This is the covenant, verse 16. This is the covenant that I will make with them. After those days, says the Lord, I will put my laws upon their heart, and upon their mind I will write them.
在第十六节说，主说那些日子以后。我与你们他们所立的约乃是这样，我要将我的律法写在他们心上，要放在他们的里面。
You see, when Moses made a covenant, they all said, all the people said amen, and it was written down in a book.
当摩西把这个神的律法记载下来的时候，这个宣读给这众人听的时候，所有人都说阿门，而且呢，把它写下来，记载在书上。
But this time, he puts his law upon our heart and our mind.
但是现在这次不是写在书上，也不是刻在石板上，乃是刻在人的心板上，放在我们的心里面。
It was put inside of us.
所以他说又要放在他们的里面。
Now listen to this. It was not attached to our clothes.Like the first covenant was.
这个新约不再是跟旧约那样，是跟我们的外面的这个衣袍有联系。
You remember the Jews? They had to write the words of the covenant and put it onto their clothes.
大家记得犹太人为了表示敬虔，他们要把什么？他们要把经文抄在这个袖子上，抄在这个。这个衣服上，这个身上。
They had written on tassels and put that on their clothes, on their robes.
在他们的这个外面的衣袍外面，如果是有这个袋子的时候，这个袋子上也都写满了经文，以此来提醒耶和华的律法。
But this new covenant has been put in your heart.
但是这新约将要刻在我们的心板上，写在我们的心上。
And you can remember what's in your heart.
所以你的心就可以记得写在你心上的这个上帝的律法。
And then in verse 17, he says, "And their sins and their lawless deeds, I will remember no more."
在第十七节怎么说？基于那个新约，他说以后就说我不再纪念他们的罪愆和他们的过犯。
Now, there's something we have to remember. Where sins have been forgiven, there is no need for any more sacrifice.
那大家有一件事要牢记，一个如果是一个祭啊，一个罪已经得赦免了，那么就不再需要有祭物了。
You look in the Old Testament about the sacrifices.
大家记得在旧约的时代献祭的时候，那些祭物。
But Cain and Abel.
啊，这个。
The story of Cain and Abel.
大家比方说在创世纪里面，这个该隐和亚伯，这个亚当的两个儿子。
Cain offered a sacrifice that God did not accept.
啊，这个该隐呢去献了个祭，但是呢是耶和华不悦纳的。
Abel offered a sacrifice that God accepted.
这个亚伯呢就去献祭，那神呢就悦纳了这个祭物。
But this is not talking about accepting an offering, a sacrifice.
但是这里不是在讲说啊、这个啊、在要啊、要去供一个祭物，这个不是这个意思。
In the new covenant, what does he give us?
在新约的时候，耶和华给我们什么呢
？He forgives our sin. We are forgiven our sins.
啊、在新约的时候，我们通过新约领受的是什么呢？是耶和华赦免，上帝赦免你我的罪。
And so because of that, in verse 19.We have confidence to enter the holy place by the blood of Jesus.
所以在第十九节说什么呢？他说我们因着耶稣的血，我们就得以坦然进入圣所。
That is because his blood was shed for us.
这个原因只有一个，就是因为耶稣的血是替你我，替我们流的。
Interesting, when the Jews offered a sacrifice, it was an animal that belonged to them.
这个很有意思。大家来想，这个很有意思的一件事情是，当旧约的时代犹太人来献祭的时候，这个祭物一定要是属于他们的祭物才可以的。
When Jesus died for us, we were his enemy.
当耶稣死在十字架上的时候，你和我。是上帝的仇敌。
It wasn't that he was the sacrifice that belonged to us.
所以耶稣这个上帝的祭物死在十字架上的时候，这个祭物不是我们的，不是我们的祭物，因为我们曾经还是他的仇敌。
But we belong to him because he created us.
反过来是因为我们是被造物，所以上帝拥有我们这些被造物的所有权。
So you see, this offering is different from the Old Testament law.
所以跟旧约时代的律法时代对这个祭物的要求相比，这次新约的祭物是完全相反的一个情况。
When we were still sinners, he died for us.
当我们还是罪人的时候，基督就为我们死。
Now, this is a new and living way. This is not like the old one.
这是一个又新的。又活的一个生命的这个道路。
You see, in verse 20, there's what says it.
在第二十节怎么说
？By a new and living way which he inaugurated for us through the veil, that is his flesh.
他说第二十节，这个希伯来书十章二十节说，是借着他给我们开了这幔子啊、这一条又新又活的路，从幔子经过，这幔子就是他的身体。
Now you remember when he died.The veil hiding God from man was torn open.
当耶稣死的时候，这个人和神之间至圣所和外面之间的那个阻隔的这道幔子呢，就开了。
In the Old Testament law, there was a veil hiding God from people.
这个根据旧约的这个在旧约的时代，那个幔子是用来阻隔上帝和人的。
But when When Jesus died on the cross, that veil was torn open.
但是当耶稣死在十字架上的时候呢，这个幔子呢就什么就裂开了。
And there was no veil hiding God from us anymore.
那么在人和神之间就再也没有阻隔了。
That had never happened before.
在人类历史上从来没有经历过这样的事。
And so, you see, it was a new way.
所以这是一条新的道路。
This wasn't in the Old Testament law. It did not do this, but in the New Covenant, this was a new way that we could get there because God was now available to us.
在旧约的时代，在旧约的祭司系统里面，这一条道路永远就从来就没有通过，因为那幔子永远就阻隔在那个地方，人不能进至圣所。但是在新约的时代，耶稣借着这个神迹的耶稣开了这条全新的道路，我们可以通过幔子裂开的地方，他的身体进到上帝的面前。
Now it was not only a new way, but remember, he died, but he rose again from the dead.
这里讲到是又新又活的路，这个不仅仅是一条新路，而且是一条活路。大家记得他从死里又复活了吗？
He returned to heaven.
他又回到天国去了。
And he sits alive.Remember that alive at God's right hand on the throne of heaven.
而且基督是活活的坐在全能上帝宝座的右边。
See, the sacrifice that was sacrificed for us is living.
这一个死替我们的罪而被献了这么一个新约的祭物，现在是什么？是一个活着的神。
So this was a new and a living way.
所以这是一个又新又活的路。
That Jesus had made for us.
那么这条路是耶稣给我们开辟的。
And so, because of what He did, we have confidence to enter that way.
因为耶稣的作为，使得我们就可以坦然无惧的来到至圣所上帝的面前。
Now, look at verse 23. This is where you read.
大家看第二十三节，刚才我们已经读了二三到二五。
And it says we are told to hold fast our confession.
他说我们要坚守我们所承认的指望。
We have confessed that Jesus is our Lord.
我们已经承认一件事情，就是耶稣是我们的主。
If we acknowledge Him as Lord, we must obey and don't let our actions deny Him.
如果我们承认耶稣是我们的主，那我们必须要顺服主，不要让我们的行为，我们嘴巴是说主啊主啊，我们的行为是否认他是我们的主。
You see, now the sermon is becoming personal, becoming personal now.
我讲到现在，我接下去要讲的事情就可能跟你就非常有关了。
Because it's pointing now at us.
因为现在这个讲到现在是具体到个人了。
We're told to hold fast the confession.
神告诉我们说，我们要坚守我们所承认的这么一个指望，这么一个福音。
And the confession is that Jesus is my Lord.
我的承认是什么？我承认耶稣是我的主，这是我嘴巴承认的。
Now, if He is Lord, then it's obvious I have to obey Him.
如果你说耶稣是我的主，那既然是你的主，你是不是要顺服你的主呢？
And I must not let my daily actions deny that fact.
我既然嘴巴说耶稣是我的主，我不能又天天活在一个否认主的生活方式里头。
See, that can happen.
这个很有可能发生的，人言行不一。
That can happen easily.
这而且是非常容易发生言行不一、心口不一的情况。
We say, Jesus is my Lord.
哦，我们说的很动听，耶稣是我的主啊。
But then, in our lives at home, we don't live it.
但是我回到家里，那去你的主，那我就是我自己是老板了。
We do not live the life of my Lord.
我活的生活不是把耶稣当我的主活了。
And then we are not holding fast.
如果 我们是这样活的，那么我们就不是坚守我们所承认的这个耶稣是主的这么一个承认。
Now it's the world that tempts us to not live what we say.
这个世界一直会诱惑我们，使得我们活出来的跟我们说出去的不一样。
But he says here, hold fast the confession, which means don't waver by the temptation of the world. Don't follow that at all.
这个二十三节什么？他说坚守我们所承认的指望，不至于动摇。因为这个世界呢，要动摇我们的信仰，要动摇我们，使得我们活，让我们活的跟说的不一样。
He has promised us eternal life with him.
神已经应许说，我们要永永远远的是这个永生跟耶稣同住。
That's more wonderful than everything in the world.
这样的应许，永生的应许是比我世界上所有一切都有吸引力。
So he is faithful. If he promises, he will do it.
上帝是信实的，神从来不说谎，所以他说的事情一定要会兑现。
So hold fast.
所以请大家要坚守。
And then we look at verse 24.
第二十四节。
This influences our relationship with each other.
这会影响我们彼此之间的关系。
And it says here, let us consider how to stimulate one another.
他这讲到说我们如何的彼此相顾，彼此激励。
And we stimulate one another to love and good deeds.
我们互相激励做什么呢？互相激发爱心，勉励行善。
Now look at this verse very carefully.
请大家小心看这些话。
We are not told to stimulate another person.
我们不是要这个圣经不是说你要去，你要激发那一个人。
We are not told to stimulate them.
我们圣经不是说你要去激发他们，其他人。
But we are told to stimulate one another.
圣经是教导我们要彼此的激励。彼此相互的激励。
That can only be done by first living love.
这个怎么才能做到呢？第一件事情就是我们要把爱活出来。
And living good deeds.
然后我们要把善活出来。
I must take care of myself first.
我必须要解决我自己的这个生活方式的问题先。
So we stimulate each other. We can't say anything to another person unless we are doing it ourselves.
所以当我们基督徒在教会里面彼此相处的时候，如果我自己都做不到的事，我就不要开口去叫别人去做。
I remember when I was still a teenager in Vietnam.
我记得我大概十几岁的时候，那时候是在越南。
I was in high school at that time.
那时候我是一个高中学生。
And one of our missionaries had not sent let her her daughter come to Dalat school like all of the rest of us.
我们当时的是我们都是宣教士的后代，所以都是这些传教士的这些孩子们。那有一年呢，就那一年呢，就是我们突然来了个新同学。这个新同学呢，他的父母呢也是宣教士，但是这个新同学原来是在另外一个学校念书的。
But she went to a French school up in Hanoi.
在河内的时候呢，他没有去读这个像我们这个宣教士的子女的学校，乃是去读了一个普通的一个法语学校。
And her friends were all those French classmates who were not Christians.
那他当然他去的时候，他的同学都不是基督徒啊，因为他在河内读一个普通的法语学校嘛。
She had grown up.In that atmosphere,
所以他是这个在什么样一种环境中长大呢？就是在一种普通的，就像我们一般的公校里面这种环境当中，一个不信主的，不是一群基督徒环境当中这样的一个情况下长大的。
But now her mother decided that she should come to our school.
现在呢，这个女孩子的这个妈妈呢，就决定说，这个我要送我的女儿，还是要去读宣教士子女的学校。
Here was we were meeting her for the first time.
但是对我们这群已经在学校里好多年的人来说呢，这个刚来的女孩子就是一个新同学。
But she had grown up in a different culture.
但是她是在另外一种环境当中长大的。
And there were things she did which were different than we. Than us.
那她的行事为人的方式，当然就跟我们就会不一样。
And there were things that, as far as we were concerned, were not quite right.
当时我们是觉得他所做的很多事情当中有很多刺可以挑的。
And like so many Christians, we had a tendency to criticize.
就像我们很多教会里面基督徒，他常常怀着一种总是拿着放大镜去找别人缺点的这样基督徒很多。
Oh, she's not living right.
你看这个人，他怎么这样了？这个样子呢？这都是不像话。
I had that in my heart.
然后呢，那个时候我就有这样一种心。
And all of us who lived in a Christian environment.We can see the difference.
那个时候我们那些高中的学生，尽管我们是高中，但是我们都是基督徒啊，我们是在基督徒环境中长大，我们就看着女孩子就怎么看都不顺眼。
And so we had that. I had that attitude towards her.
那个时候我也有这么一种挑刺儿的那种求全责备的那种吹毛求疵的那种态度。
But one day, and I don't know how God did it.
有一天我也不知道神怎么样在我的这个头脑里面，我的心里动了什么功。
The Lord said to me, "Betty isn't so bad."
这个女孩子名字叫 Betty， 她说呢，这个神对我说 ，Franklin， 这个 Betty 并不像你想象的这么坏啊，她没什么大问题啊。
And so I made the statement, but I wasn't really saying it to anybody.
因为神对我这样讲呢，我就嘴巴就念念有词的，我就在那里孤单对自己说的，我就自言自语，我就把这个话说出来，旁边的同学都听到了。
I made the statement, and my friends were around me.
那时候有一帮的男孩子都在我边上，我就突然就冷不丁的自言自语说了这么一句话。
I said I can't remember just the words, but it's something like, "Betty's not really bad. She's good."
那时候我不知道，我现在记不清，但是那个是我他因为牧师十几年前的这个事，这个十几岁的时候的事儿，所以他就不记得，但他当时。说了一句话，也就是说，这个女孩子 Betty 并没有，也没有什么，她其实还挺不错的。
But I remember when I was explaining this to Michael, I was not really saying it to my friends.
这个我曾经那个前两天我跟 Michael 讲这个事情的时候，我都很记得，我说这个话的时候，我的意思不是要说给我身边这些男孩子听的。
I was saying that to myself.
我实际上是自言自语对自己说的。
I was talking to the attitude that I had before.
我是对我自己对 Betty 的这个错误的这个态度和那种错误的这种这个行事方式对我自己的问题说的。
And all of us had the same attitude.
我那一帮的伙计们都是同都这帮这男孩子都是同一个态度。
But I had to talk to me.
但是呢，神感动我以后，我要对自己先纠正自己的错误。
And later, one of my friends. Said how that he was amazed at what I said.
后来很多年以后，我的一个朋友告诉我的这帮男同学当中有一个同学跟我讲，他说他当时非常觉得非常的奇妙。
And he said to me, he says, "What you said was true. I all of a sudden saw it."
他说那天实际听你自言自语一说以后呢，我心里突然也是说，是啊，这个情况确实跟你说的差一样啊，没错，他没有这么坏啊。
What I said stimulated him.
这个男孩子后来告诉我，他说
stimulated him to love.
那一天我所说的这个话是激励了他去爱这个新来的同学。
But I was not talking to him. I was talking to myself.
但是那个时候我的目的，我的动机不是要叫他去爱这个新来的同学，乃是我对自己。再说，我要应该要去爱这个新来的女同学。
So you see, hold fast to the confession.
所以这里讲到说，我们要坚守我们所承认的。
Then you can stimulate one another.
当我们自己坚守我们所做的，我们自己活出来的时候，我们才可以彼此激励。
And you stimulate one another to love and good deeds.
我们彼此激励的目的是什么呢？是要激发爱心，而且是要。彼此勉励行善。
You don't stimulate one another to be critical of each other.
我们不是彼此激励，然后在那火上浇油，在那里就是彼此的指责、谩骂、相咬相吞。
Now the next verse in this passage you read here, says, "If we love each other, we want to be with each other."
这个后面的这个第二十五节怎么说？如果我们真的是彼此相爱的话，我们就想要在一起一同的聚会。
That's why it says, "Don't forget assembling with each other."
所以第二十五节说，你们不可停止聚会。
You see, when we assemble with each other, what we're doing is stimulating each other.
因为当我们在一起聚会的时候，我们其中也做一件事什么？就是在彼此的激励。
Now, let's talk about the assembly.
我们现在来讲一讲什么叫做聚会。
We meet together to worship God.
我们聚会，基督徒礼拜天一起的聚会是敬拜神。
So all of us here are meeting here to worship God.
我们今天在座的这个弟兄姐妹，大家在一起是为了敬拜神。
We meet together to fellowship with each other.
我们在一起是彼此在主里面有交通。
We meet together to learn together.
我们一同的聚会 是一同的学习神的话。
We meet together to stimulate each other to love and good deeds.
我们在一起聚会是彼此的互相的激励，激发爱心，彼此的勉励去行善。
We meet together to encourage each other.
我们在一起聚会是彼此的鼓励。
Not to criticize each other, to encourage each other.
我们是彼此的鼓励，彼此的安慰，彼此不是彼此的指责，彼此的谩骂。
You know what? That is a foretaste of the fellowship that we're going to have in heaven.
大家知道，我们在礼拜天在教会的聚会，是我们将来要在天上的聚会的那个预尝，我们预先先尝一口这个味道。
So the writer of Hebrews is telling us, start doing it down here, so that when you get up there, you won't be embarrassed.
所以希伯来书的作者是告诫我们，我们在地上的时候，先要去排练一下，我们将来要在天上的，要不然你到了天上去聚会的时候，你就会很尴尬，因为你什么都不知道。
Look what Jesus did to make this possible for us.
我们要看耶稣已经付出了多么巨大的代价，使得我们可以奉他的名在一起聚会。
He left home, he came down, he died.
他离开他在天上的家，他离开他的父亲，来到地上。
And you know what?He is waiting to receive us.
这死而复活的主现在做什么？他在等待我们，要把我们接去，将来到天上与我们同住。
He is waiting to receive us to be with him up there in heaven.
他是在这个等待，要把我们接去，接到天上去，让我们与他同住。
He is preparing for that fellowship that we're going to have up there.
他是今天在教会里面，他是要预备我们和睦同居，使得我们到天上也可以和睦同居。
So this injunction or this what he's telling us to do is really serious now.
所以现在在这一段的讲道，实际上对基督徒是非常严厉的、非常重要的一个告诫。
Hold fast the confession of our hope.
他说：“你们要坚守你们所承认的指望。”
When we're holding fast the confession of our hope, we're not thinking about anybody else. We're only thinking about ourselves.
当我们说坚守我们所承认的这个指望的时候，是什么意思呢？你不要去管别人活不活得出来，你自己先把它活出来再说。
And holding that confession of our hope, we're looking for people who are also holding fast that confession of hope.
当我们坚守我们所传的，我们活出我们嘴巴所传的福音的那个主的时候呢，我们就是去要去勉励那些也是坚守神的这个承认的指望。
And we stimulate ourselves to love and good works.
所以我们要这个自我的激励，彼此的勉励，来行善，来爱，彼此相爱。
And that will spill over to our friends.
当我们这样的爱在我们当中满溢出来的时候，这样的爱满溢出来，爱才能流淌到我们生命中那些还没有认识主的人。
And then don't forsake assembling together.Like we're doing this morning.
因为这个缘故，所以基督徒不可停止聚会。就像我们今天早上在教会的这样聚会，我们不可停下来。
And then be diligent to do it. We be diligent. I be diligent for myself. Not try to get tell anybody, but I must be diligent.
我要这个很勤奋的去做这个事情。我不能有给任何的机会和借口，说我礼拜天不能来了。我不能跟基督徒聚会了，我自己要先做到。
Why must I be diligent to do it?
那请问为什么我要这么勤勉的去做这件事情，要去聚会呢？
As you see the day of drawing near.
最后一句25节的最后半句话什么？他说：“既知道那日子临近。”
Today we have the chance.
今天我们还有机会在地上聚会。
To confess Jesus as our Lord.
我们在地上聚会的时候，可以这个承认基督是我们的主。
Once he comes, once the trumpet sounds, there'll be no more chance.
当这个号吹响的时候，基督复临的时候，把我们带走的时候，大家在地上就没有机会。
But as the day is drawing near, you and I who already have the hope, we must be diligent to live the life that He wants us to live.
为了要预备好，在这个号角吹响，我们能被带走的话，我们今天在地上，我们现在在主回来之前，我们要非常的勤勉，我们要相互的激励，我们要彼此的相爱，而且我们要勉励行善。
And we must stimulate each other. We must stimulate each other by living the way that each other are supposed to live.
我们彼此怎如何的彼此相互激励呢？我们彼此相互激励是什么？就我也把我嘴巴说的那个主当作主在我生命中活出来，你也是一样，大家都把主在我们生命中活出来，这样就是最好的彼此的激励。
Jesus coming back very soon.
耶稣很快，非常快就要回来。
That's going to be wonderful.
这是一件奇妙美好的事。
We can live like we're supposed to up there now.
我们现在就可以把要在天上活的生命就活在地上，现在就活出来。
But don't let our lives deny what our words say.
所以我奉劝诸位，不要用我们自己的行为去否定我们所传的福音。
Now I want us to pray.
我们现在要来祷告。
And I want us all to pray.
我想诸位在座每一位都要祷告。
And you can guess what the subject would be.
大家可以猜想我们要祷告什么。
To you pray for yourself.
每个人都要为自己祷告。
Pray that you will live the life that would encourage each other.
我们要祷告，就是我们的行事为人，我的生活方式，我自己的生活方式，行事为人，能够什么？成为对别人的一种激励。
So that if someone were pointing out to us something in our lives, we wouldn't get offended.
所以呢，使得当有人在我的生命中指出，弟兄，你这件事没做好，姊妹你这件没做好的时候，你不会暴跳如雷。
It's like what Alex said to us there. The pastor held a stone and he says, every one of us deserves to be stoned.
就像刚才 Alex 弟兄在领圣餐的时候分享的一样，很多的人，每一个人，实际上配得的不是在那里指手画脚讲别人，乃是配得的都是被石头打死，因为我们都是罪人。
So we cannot look at anybody else, we can only look at ourselves.
所以我们常常要做的事情是什么呢？我们要检查自己，我们要检验自己是不是活的跟我们传的福音相一致。
And pray, Lord, please help me to hold fast my confession that I will not go offAnd start thinking that I am better than I really am.
所以我们使得我们可以坚守我们所承认的指望，不至于摇动。我们更不会被诱惑，自认为是你看这些人，你看我多好。
You understand what you have to pray for?
大家知道我们现在要祷告是什么东西吗
？Pray for yourself.
所以大家为自己向神来求告。
Okay, Michael closes.Father God, I pray, O Lord, thank you for what you've done with Jesus. O Lord, I pray. You are the Lord, I confess, you are more than your friends. You are my Lord. You are my Lord. O Lord, help me to obey you. Obey you all the time. O Lord God, I pray, so that my life will be able to influence others.To stimulate others to love and good works. Oh Lord God, I pray that you will help me, Lord. And Lord, if there's anything I've done which is displeasing, please help me. Oh Lord God, I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.Thank you.
Father, we thank you for this message. Thank you that we can pray to you for ourselves. Father, I pray to you for myself that I will always humble before you in recognition of who you are and who I am, in recognition of you are the Lord and I am created being. And I was a sinner, lost. Now I'm a sinner saved by you through the work you have done on the cross. Thank you that, Father, you put me in this congregation to fellowship with one another, to encourage each other, to pray for each other, to love one another, to stimulate each other for good deeds, to stimulate each other one another for love. Father, we do not generate love. We do not create love. We don't have love at all. But all our love from you. May I, myself, and all of us recognize you are the source of love, just as much as you are the source of life. When we talk about love one another, when we talk about do good deeds, we have to recognize you are the source. So, Father, we come before you, I come before you, that to pray that, Father, you have mercy on me, on us, that we will humble before you, and we will humble before each other, and we will not deny the gospel we preach. We will not, in our living, we will not deny the gospel we speak to our relatives and our friends through our bad living. Father, may we live what we preach. Father, may our lives be a glory for this glorious gospel, not a shame. Father, may my life bring pleasure and glory to your name. We thank you. And Father, may we not only pray for myself, for ourselves, may we remember constantly that may we remember to pray one another in love, in your love, in the kindness and goodness from you. We thank you. 主啊，我们感谢你，我们有这么一个美好的神，我们可以祈求祷告。今天我自己先来到你的面前，谦卑在你的面前。但愿我们每一个我们的会众都一样，时时常常的谦卑在主的面前，为自己来求。主啊，我们求告的时候，我们要知道你是谁，我们要认清自己的身份，使得我们不至于拿指头点你点别人，我们拿指头点自己，知道我们都是罪人。我们站在那里指责别人的时候，我们不能像法利赛人那样，我们做事情的时候，我们不能那么的自私，出于自己的利益、自己的爱好、自己的好恶、自己的这个人际关系的清净。主啊，乃是要出于神，出于建造主的教会。主啊，我们凡事都可行，但不都造就人。我们凡事都可行，但不都有益处。但愿我们所做所想的都是为了主，但愿我们所活出来的行为不至于否定我们所传讲的福音。我们但愿我们基督徒不至于在世界上落着一个笑柄，就是我们说的一套，我们活的是另外一套。主啊，很多的人被绊倒，不是因为基督徒口里的福音，乃是基督徒活出来的跟福音正好相反。主啊，但愿你怜悯我们，我们没有基督徒可以跟活的跟福音一模一样，我们活不到跟基督一样的完美。但是主啊，你要怜悯我们，使得我们意识到这一点的时候，我们才会谦卑在你的面前。主啊，基督徒不是发光体，基督徒不是发光源，基督徒乃是一个透明体，基督徒乃是要让住在我们里面的福音发出光来。主啊，我们越昏暗，福音的光就越暗淡；我们越透明，基督的光就越明亮，福音的光就越灿烂。但愿我们不做那阻挡福音之光的人，但愿我们都是做一个透明的 像基督的身体被打开一样，像基督的身体被穿透一样。但愿主你的福音的光从我们身体里面穿出来，不受我们的阻挡，不受我们邪恶的念头的阻挡，不受我们自己邪情私欲的阻挡。主啊，但愿我自己不做福音之光的阻挡，但愿我们不绊倒人，但愿我们到了天上没有一个下地的灵魂是因为被我们绊倒而下去。主啊，感谢你，但愿我们彼此相爱，彼此代求，但愿我们想什么事做什么事都想着主，想着教会先，不要想着自己先，先别想着自己的儿子，想想别人的儿子，先别想着自己的利益，先想想别人的利益。但愿我们彼此的激励，我们也彼此的代求。主啊，基督是最伟大的代祷士，我们今天也是一样。主啊，我们彼此相爱，不光是行在面前，我们在背后，主啊，我们也彼此的代求代祷，求你怜悯我们，求你怜悯我们你的教会。我们感谢主，感谢这样美好的信息，我们这样祷告，奉主耶稣基督的圣名。 Amen.